Good evening and welcome to the AJ Bell Stadium for the 2016 Rugby Varsity match between the University of Manchester and Manchester Metropolitan University. We will get straight away and get the team news for you, starting off with the UniOv, with number one being Rimmer, number two Mowat, number three Salah, number four Thane, number five Chapman, number six Johansson, number seven Harrison, number eight Marmion, number nine Calvert, number 10 Reed, number 11 Nylander, number 12 Bradley, number 13 Dudman Jones, number 14 Hunt, and number 15 Edwards.
And with the Man Met team, number 1 Griffin Parry, number 2 Nairn, number 3 Phillips, number 4 Francis, number 5 Roebuck, number 6 Rees, number 7 Thompson, number 8 Chapman, number 9 Wilson, number 10 Brown Raw, number 11 Kelly, number 12 Wilkinson, number 13 Russell Vick, number 14 Perry, and number 15 Davies.
And your commentators this evening are myself, Josh Jenkins,
and myself, Harry Newton.
And we're starting off with the UniOv team coming out onto the field.
A good slap from a fella in chinos to get him going at the start of the game. Exactly what you need, isn't it? Sporting the university colours of purple and gold there, with a dash of black.
And then the Man Met team as well, who are playing in white, black and orange this evening. This is the first Man Met rugby varsity match in 2 years, I believe, Harry.
Yeah, they haven't played each other for a while. I think they've been running scared a little bit, the Man Met team.
Yeah. That's the rumour going around the campus.
Haven't won in a long time.
And Manchester Met will be kicking us off and get the 2016 Rugby Varsity match underway.
You can see the crowd segregation already, can't you? That they're keeping them separate because of this rivalry.
Yes. There is a buzz in the air.
Fantastic stadium for a varsity, isn't it?
It is. Nice facilities, nice pitch as well. And here we go. Deep kick. And that is a knock on there by UniOv. And the ref's finally blown up to give it as well. Took his time. Here we are, it's a scrum to Man Met.
Did you just complain about the referee 30 seconds into the game then?
I did.
This is going to be great commentary.
Yes. A little bit hesitant start by the ref tonight.
Might very well be nervous with that crowd there as well.
Yes. And the scrum half Wilson is going to be delivering the ball in for this Man Met scrum. Takes a while sometimes for scrums to fully get going in a game. A very annoying law in the rule of rugby. There we go, that looks a bit better. That looks a lot better. And Wilson's going to deliver in the ball in. And that is a successful scrum for Man Met. Brings the ball out. There. And that is a foul by UniOv. And looks like a foul. I think it should be a penalty. Nope, it's going to be another scrum to Man Met.
It's a bit difficult to work out what the decisions of the referee is, isn't it?
It is. Obviously, in normal professional rugby union matches, the referee normally has a microphone, which the audience and our commentators ourselves can hear the exact reasons why he is given these decisions, because sometimes it can be a bit confusing to tell the difference between a drop ball or maybe a foul in a ruck or a maul, etc. This is a scrum for UniOv, which has been delivered in, and it looks pretty successful and has been brought out, and play is underway again, and it's a long kick forward. Man Met with the ball coming forward.
Yeah.
me then. On the left-hand side, you're with Man Met. Wilson gives the ball up from the ruck. There's a lot of numbers over here on the right-hand side for Man Met if they get the ball over quickly enough. So they've got the numbers there. Number 13, Dudman Jones, is quite isolated on the right-hand side, and they're not really... Mamet haven't really taken advantage of that, but they're on the right-hand side now. Another ruck. And that is a penalty for Mamet. And it appeared there to be going into the ruck off his hands there from the UniOrg player. That's what the foul there was given for. And a penalty now for Mamet, being kicked in. And he's actually missed touch there. That poor error there by the Mamet kicker that has gone all the way out. And we'll be having a drop kick by UniOrg.
Do you think there will be an element of nerves with these players? Obviously not used to playing in such of a big crowd.
There's bound to be. It's quite a big game as well. Obviously these, in normal Bucks fixtures, I doubt they'd be playing in a crowd of this capacity, really. It's normally probably... A lot smaller. So, and the hype as well. Tickets have been sold well in advance as well. So the hype around this game is quite a lot as well. And so yeah, there's bound to be an extra added pressure that they normally wouldn't have in other games. But this is a scrum now for UniOrg, going to be delivered in. And that is dropping down there. Like I said, scrums can be a quite annoying part of the game of rugby union. They do something that really does need to be sorted out by the powers that be, because they can sometimes take an age to get sorted.
If you think that's cramped, try and get on a magic bus at 9 o'clock on a Tuesday.
There you go, that's a successful scrum. Number 13. And it's ball moving out to the right. Ooh, bit of a fumble there. And they're now running back to their own try line, and Mamet have taken advantage of this, and I think is that going to be a turnover ball? No, it hasn't. Scrum half has got it a bit well. UniOrg, so deciding to run the ball out here, UniOrg. And they've got numbers on the left-hand side, and number 14, Hunt, with the ball. And they've done well there to get out, but a tricky position there, have UniOrg. And the ref has blown. And it looks like it's going to be another scrum.
Another one.
That's the third scrum already in the opening 6 minutes of this game. So like we said as well earlier, there's obviously a lot of nerves in a game like this as well. So it does take a while maybe for the players to get settled and play in their normal rugby.
It's difficult to prepare for something like this, isn't it? You can train all week long all the things that you want to do in the game. But to put it into action is difficult. You know, even if you don't take into action the audience.
It's very difficult to play a normal game in circumstances like this. But that's fine now, number 9. Scrum has been delivered in again by Wilson, and successful scrum again. Our man met with the ball towards the 22 now, the UniOrg try line, that's good play. And they got numbers on the left here, a lot of numbers on the left. And this is so close to the try line. Mamet now. And we're going to a TV decision. He looked like he got the ball over then, actually. And the referee has awarded the try. And Mamet have scored the first try in this game. And it's only taken 7 minutes, and the game is Mamet lead 5-0.
Good work from the scrum, and the referee's given that one. That's the last thing that University of Manchester will want that early on, isn't it?
Yeah, that's a good way to settle the nerves as well. If you're Mamet, now they can relax and play their own game now.
Should be a nice kick up the bottom as well.
Yes.
The University of Manchester. Nothing to settle your nerves and wanting to go and get back one yourself.
And now we'll be having a conversion and see if Mamet can add 2 extra points onto the scoreboard. Pretty difficult kick this. It's quite diagonal, so it's going to be a challenging kick gear to make the conversion. It'll be taken by number 10, Harrison Brown-Raw, and this is his first kick of the day. And
you could tell it was his first kick of the day, couldn't you?
Yeah, just wide of the right-hand side post there. So the score remains. It is the Uni of Manchester 0, Manchester Metropolitan University 5. Good start there, though, Harry, for Man Met. Exactly what they want. Exactly what they would have wanted.
Perfect start for them.
Thing as well, I mean, it's... So Uni of get us back underway here. With a very deep kickoff there as well. It's been knock-on. Second time from a kickoff has been a knock-on, and no man, Uniov, yeah, there's no advantage there, so the ref has rightly given the penalty. Or scrum, I should say, sorry. First time as well, coincidentally, in this game that Uniov have been in Manchester Mets 22. So, yeah.
Still see the fans still taking their seats there.
Yes. Here we go, and the scrum's going to be delivered in now. Looks like a good scrum. The ref's all happy. And here we go. Another success. The scrummage has been very good so far this evening in the early start of this game.
Also, how good a
nice
word.
Nice offload. Sorry, carry on.
How good a word is scrummage?
It's a very nice word.
It's a fantastic word.
Now there's player. There's numbers on the right again here. Numbers on the right. Ooh, gone through. Quick ball. And now Uniov are right next to the try line here. Now this could be a very good response. Just cycle through that puck. Bounce is going to work. And it's a quick response by Uniov. And it is a try back within minutes. And it is 5-5 here. And that was a great response there from Uniov.
Shaping up to be a great game, isn't it? Response that quickly.
That was a great response there by the Uniov boys. It's the first time as well they've been towards the Man Met territory as well, and they got a try straight away. So it was a great response. That will settle them down now as well.
They'll be disappointed with that as well, Manchester Metropolitan.
Yes. It's like they say in football, you're most vulnerable when you've just scored.
That's
true. And that surely is applied there to Man Met. It all started as well there with the poor take from the kickoff as well. Put them under pressure from the scrum, and Uniov took their chance, and it's now back on level terms. We go to the very another tough conversion here, right in the corner. Takes it, and it's a that's dragged it quite a lot there to the left, and the scores remain 5-5. Good start here at the AJ Bell Stadium. So, Man Met about to get us back underway. Another deep kickoff. And taken there by number 10, Reed. Number 8 with a good run. Nice run there by the number 8. And get the ball out. He's changed his mind there, and he's gone with the kick in the end. And that's a nice kick into touch there. Very nice kick and good running as well there by the number 11, Nylander, to stop the quick line out. So we have a line out here, it's Man Met line out. Line-up going to be taken by the number 2, Nen. And that is a successful line-up there. First line-up of the night for Man Met, and a successful one. Now we have a driving maul.
with the running ball. There's a lot of room. Gets the ball out there to the right hand side on a little kick and out of touch. And it could be their lineup as well. I don't know whether that came off the Union player then. It looks like it's going to be a Mamet lineup.
Like we're back in the 70s, isn't it? No replays, none of that business. No mic from the referee.
No. But it is a UniOv.
It looked like it was. That's
I thought that came
I thought that came off a UniOv player there, but anyway, it's number Moat there to bring in the lineup for UniOv.
And it definitely didn't look straight, that didn't it? That went quite a bit to the right there, and the referee. Oh, the ref's letting them retake it, which is surely was not straight, but oh well. And it's an interception there, it's a lost ball there by UniOv, and Mamet have taken it. Good interception there. And that is a penalty for Mamet. And they're going to go for goal, they're going to go for the 3 points. Right decision there. And a good chance now for Manmet to retake the lead on the scoreboard.
The bench certainly seems to think that they will. They were very animated then.
Games like it's all about getting the upper hand in games like this as well, with big games like this. Any points you can take at any point in the match is well needed, because it will be fine margins tonight. And good chance here from Ahmet now with the penalty. And no, he didn't take the chance, didn't convert it. And the scores remain at 5-5. It's going to be a...
I wonder where he bought them slippers from that he's wearing today with them kicks.
So ask him.
Hopefully it's 2-for-1. Get me a pair and get you a pair as well. Yeah.
So UniOv gets back underway now. Yeah. There's a good chance there for Mamet as well to retake the lead. He'd be disappointed there after 0-from-2 in the kicks as well. So UniOv got back underway. It's a low pass there. It's recovered it quite nicely there, the Mamet player, and now out here on the left hand side. Come back in. Oof. Well, Mamet getting quick ball now on this right hand side. Yeah. Nice bit of ball possession again, you know, by Manmet into the ruck. Oh, Manmet bringing the ball back on, moving side for a sec. Manmet very good in possession at the moment as well, going through a number of phases. They're holding the ball a lot better than UniOv have been at the moment. And it's been a good response by Mamet as well, Harry, conceding the try. Because obviously it would have been a bit disappointing by them only being ahead for just a couple of minutes. It's been a pretty good response.
Yeah, UoM had a great response to the try from Mamet. But then since then, Mamet have just taken the game into their control.
Yes, and they'd be very happy with the start. Well, it's going to be a scrum to UniOv.
Or a scrummage, as you said before, my favourite word in the world.
So far, 100%. On the scrum so far. They've been
top-notch scrummage.
Yes, and it's going to be delivered in again by Calvert for UniOv. And another successful one there. Now the run, UniOv with the ball, and Nylander was over there, and he wasn't given the ball on the right-hand side. He was free in the wing, but and there we have another penalty for UniOv.
Nylander's an excellent name. Sounds like a vigilante. If you are listening, Nylander, you have an exceptional name.
And they've gone for the kick there. They've gone to put it in the touch. And positive thinking there, positive tactics by UoM. They're going for the 5 points. Not happy with just the three. They want to go for the try. Always like to see that. Positive, ambitious rugby.
Mm.
So the lineup will be brought in here by Mowat again. And that's a successful lineup there. Now UoM with a good chance here in the 22.
Not quite sure what's happened there.
Neither
am I. There, Josh?
Appeared to be a knock on. I think there was a knock on there by UoM.
Sad this commentary lag, isn't it? You know, seeing what's going on live. I'm freezing up here as well. Cue for a hot pie. Miles long. Miles.
Like we said before, just to clarify again, it is sometimes a little bit tricky when the ref doesn't have a mic on him, so sometimes it could be a lot clearer in terms of the exact reasons why he would give a scrum or a penalty or whatever reason. So number 9 for Mehmet here, Wilson will be delivering the ball in again for the scrum. Important here to have a successful scrum because they're so close to their own try line. It out and a successful kick, a really good kick there as well. They've got themselves out of the danger there. To Nylander, number 11, for UoM, sorry.
It's great that Nylander could do that with his cape on, wasn't it?
It was. Another thing I've noticed as well so far in these opening 20 minutes is both teams are looking to play passing rugby. UoM, for the second time, they've been in a little position, they've passed the ball out rather than taking the kicking option. Which is another thing nice to see as well.
They're here to entertain the crowd that have paid money, aren't they?
So UoM over the ball again, you know. In the ruck, a little ruck here now on the near left-hand side.
I say entertain the crowd. I'm looking down now and I think they're entertaining themselves with these chants and dances.
Now again, the numbers again out wide. If UoM can take it out, can bring the ball out. Decide to go to the left-hand side instead. And now, number 4. Ball here with Hunt. And that has gone out, and that is a line-out for Manmet. UoM imposing themselves on the game a bit more now, you Harry.
Yeah, they're coming into it a bit, because there was a great response from Manmet then. It's definitely going to be a tight one, this, isn't it?
It is. Both teams are evenly matched. So we now have the Mehmet lineout. Going to be taken by Nan. And that has been intercepted there by UoM. And it's really been turned over though by Mehmet. Mehmet have ended up with the ball. Not in a conventional way, but in the end they got the ball back. It's been kicked forward. Ooh, that was a nasty one. They got number 4. Hunt there seems to be okay. Got the ball. Actually catched. And now Mehmet bring the ball forward again now. The offload. And now this is a great play. Nice play. There by Kelly. He's made a great run here by number 11 Kelly. And this looks, he's just missed the offload as well. There was a great chance there with Brown Raw, who was free. Chance there. Yeah, but a great run there by Kelly.
Fantastic run.
Completely slipped the fence open there. Kelly with his run. Just missed that offload. And Brown Raw would have been clear. So we have a scrum. It was a knock on. Uni off scrum, yeah. So you just think situations like this now as well, with the referee just commenting on why he wants to scrum, why he's paused the scrum. Sometimes, obviously, it's a lot easier when they have them, like, just to clarify again. That looks pretty good to me. And UoM bring the ball back in. And another successful scrum, and now UoM have the ball, and successful scrum there, got themselves out of quite a tricky position there. And the offload was unsuccessful, and Mamech have retaken the ball. And we're bringing the ball out on the left hand side now, and with this kick. And that has got a touch, and that will be a Mamech line out there from the kick. Okay, so it's a penalty for UoM. That was due to the late tackle there after the UoM player kicked the ball. Okay. A bit of a pause in play here at the moment. And I think it would be a good time to mention the women's game earlier today, because there was a women's match.
Yeah, it wasn't as tight as this game is. What score was that one? I've forgotten what it was in the end. I've got it written down, though. To UoM.
Oh, so it was fantastic, a very dominant win there by the ladies' team. And the men are hoping to replicate that performance. It's going to be a bit of a tighter game, this, though.
Well, the ladies for Man Met got nothing until the second half. So they've already done slightly better here.
Yeah, they have.
The Man Met lads.
So, yeah, back in play now. There's a scrum for Man Met. So yeah, scrum now for Man.
Looks a little bit like a formation that Boyzone would have before they go on to sing a song there, doesn't it? Look at that, they're all holding hands, down we go.
Okay, another successful scrum there for Man Met. And now they brought the ball out again.
Do you think viewers have realised that I'm not the rugby expert of the two so far?
No, I don't think so.
No, do you think I've not given that away?
Another good run by Kelly. And he's done well there, darting through a few players now. And the ball is right on the halfway, with Man Met in possession.
That's got to be handball, that. No? No. Okay, back to the rugby.
Man Met have the ball here now. The early part of this game have been characterised by a large number of phases by Man Met at the moment. They're a lot better in possession than UoM at the moment.
They are.
Standout player so far for me, number 11, Frank Kelly, who's made a number of impressive forward runs for Man Met at the moment.
Oh, there was a great one earlier, wasn't there, where he almost went through.
There was.
Fantastic hairdo as well. That is one impressive Barnett.
I've noticed, it's very good.
I've personally just gone for a shot back inside, but I think that was the wrong decision from me, wasn't it?
Yeah. I think he's definitely going to win the award for the hairstyle of the match.
Oh yeah, we won't do man of the match, we'll do hairstyle of the match. Vigilante of the match. Yeah.
But anyway, back to the game, and now we have a Man Met lineout. Deep into uni of territory here as well.
From a man with an average haircut.
Going to be taken by George Nairn. And it's a deep, long lineout, which was successfully taken there by number 7, Thompson. And we put the ball out as well here now, and Thompson again's running in. Well, that was Nairn, sorry. Man Met just trying to forge an opening here towards the try line there with number 15, Davis, just been tackled. Man Met are definitely looking a bit more comfortable there on the ball, aren't they?
Mm. Faster the way that they move the ball.
Yes. Making him patient play is what. That's how they're doing it as well. Nice, they're bringing the ball out to the left-hand side here now. Yeah, with number 10, Brown Rowe just been tackled. Good tackle there by the number 13 for Uni of Dedmon Jones, and now the ball's being taken back to the left.
Saying how good Man Met are, but Uni of are not letting them in easily here.
No, the defence is holding up quite nicely there, and that's going to be a penalty to Uniov. You are correct there, Harry. It was very good defence there by Uniov. But the thing is, the amount of tackles that they are at the moment making, it will tire them out quite considerably as the game goes on. They do need to get hold of the ball a lot more and start imposing themselves on the game, as Man Met are definitely the team on top at the moment.
That's why the crowd really needs to get behind UoM as well, because that adrenaline that the crowd will give them just gives them 5 more minutes, doesn't it?
It does.
You're that tired, gives you 5 more minutes.
So there's going to be a UniOff scrum now, and it's going to be taken by the number 9, Caldwell again.
Scrums have been excellent so far today.
They have. And now UniOff with the ball again. That one with the ruck, and scrum off, releases the ball, nice play. Caldwell fiddling on the ball a bit there. Caldwell has finally released it.
Have you ever noticed that the Man Met logo looks a little bit like the Reuse Recycle logo?
No, I haven't. I don't actually know what the Man Met. Oh, but there.
It's up there at the top. Of our sheet of paper.
That is true. That does look a lot like. It is. Literally, like they've gone, I can't find a logo.
Yeah, so we'll just
logo.
Reuse this one. That's what it's there for. Witty and sporty,
yes.
That's what we are, isn't it?
Okay, so there's going to be a penalty taken by Reed, and he's kicked for touch there, and we're going to have a UniOv lineup.
Just enough time for me to pass you some magic stars, Josh.
Thank you, Harry. Unsuccessful lineup there, taken by Man Met.
Lineups have been nowhere near as successful as all the scrums in this game.
They haven't, Harry. You're correct there. Maybe we'll have another scrum. Another big part of this game so far has been the amount of knock-ons and the amount of scrums, obviously mostly I'd say down to nerves. This is one sign of when you are nervous in a rugby match is the knock-ons, but they are settling down a lot more now. The game has become a lot more free-flowing than the earlier period.
And I think it may be building up to a big second half this game.
Reed with a kick towards forward, and kicked back downfield there by Man Met, taken well again by Reed, and now he's coming forward. Move in to the left hand side. over the kick, and it's well taken there by Mamet. And now they start a counter attack.
That's interesting. The sponsor there is the University of Salford. We're all involved this game.
That's
quite nice.
Nice to get Salford involved, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because
they're another day out.
They're just a kind of the third wheel, aren't they? They're just not really.
They really are the third wheel.
They're just no one really cares about Salford. Do you care about Salford?
No.
No, no one
it's
does.
It's not even Manchester, is it?
No, it's not
Manchester. Okay, then again, telling that we've gone to Salford to play this game.
Yeah,
fantastic stadium. There's not many around in Manchester that we could have used.
No.
Signed out for next year as
well.
It's
a line-up by Mamet anyway. It's coming through here. The Nan. Who's going to deliver the ball back in. Successful line-up there. Now Mamet moving the ball quite quickly here towards the left. Cutting field. Wilkinson there just got tackled.
He was born to play rugby with a name like Wilkinson, wasn't he?
Yes. No, Mamet with the ball.
Yes, I understand it's a common name.
But a little bit fumbly there, and I think that was a knock-on there by Mamet. Looked like a knock-on there by number two, Nan. It was Thompson there with the knock-on. Another knock-on in this game, but... So we're just going to be awaiting the scrum now to be delivered in by UniOv. And Calvert is just going to be waiting as again with scrums. It's very irritating in the game. It does take a while to get fully going.
It takes longer for a scrum to happen in this game than it does for Oxford Road to get all undug up.
That's the case, not just with university rugby, it's the case as well with professional rugby. It's a big stain on the current game. The ref seems to have done well there. It's another successful scrum, well done by the UniOv. And that is a scrum that the referee has given. So we've got Mamet scrum here, going to be delivered in by the number 9, Jack Wilson. There we go, ball's back in play. Mamet now attacking into the 22 of UniOv. The dummy pass has just been tackled. Is a penalty for Mamet. That was a scrum, I do apologise.
It's that ref mic, that's what we need.
Yeah.
Ref mic.
It'd been very handy.
If the referee's called Mike, is it Ref Mike's Mike?
No? Imagine so.
Good analysis.
Okay, so Wilson is going to be delivering this ball in again now. And that is a penalty. for Man Met, and a good chance maybe. Are they going to go for the points towards the end of the half? Do we have the half time of the lead? No, they're going to go for the full five, which is an interesting tactic, so close to the end of the half. What do you have gone for there, Harry?
Well, I know that we were praising going for the five earlier, but this close to the end of the game, I'd be quite happy to take the lead and go for go for any points.
Yeah, I agree. So line up here, Mamet, and a successful one as well. They're right towards the try line now. And it's been turned over with the knock on, and Union have got the ball back. And then we go back to the point there. Maybe it would have been cleverer to have gone for the 3 points there.
Well, I did say that they could have hired me as their tactician.
It was quite an easy kick, quite a makeable kick as well, I'm sure.
They may rue to regret that one. Yeah. Who do you think will be happier going into the half-time break?
I think Mamet will probably be the happier team.
Mm.
At the moment, they've had a lot more of the ball. They've been better in possession. They've had the better moments. They switched off. The only time they switched off was when they scored the first try, and they conceded straight after it. But apart from that, I think they'd be very happy with how they've played this game so far.
I think they definitely have the psychological advantage for the second half.
They have been the better. UniOv just need a... be more involved in Man Met's territory. They play a lot of their rugby in their own half. So something they need to try and sort out amongst themselves going into the second half. But obviously we've still got a bit of the first to play down, and they've got to go through a successful scrum here. And that was good play, and number 8. Marmion with the ball now. Just been tackled, and UniOv just want to get this ball out now. Quite a dangerous position. They don't really want to be messing, and they've got the penalty. And that should be the end of the half. With them kicking the ball out.
Time for a tangerine and a wet wipe in the dressing rooms, I think.
Yep, and that is not going to be half.
Oh, it is. We're done.
Yeah. That's half time, and it's University of Manchester 5, Manchester Metropolitan University 5. Stalemate so far in the 2016 Rugby Varsity match.
And the fans are loving it, clapping them in as they walk in. That must feel good, mustn't it? I don't get clapped when I walk into the office. I could introduce that. Would you clap me if I walked in the office?
No.
Okay, that's fine.
So yeah, half time, it's University of Manchester 5, Manchester Metropolitan University 5. And the second half will begin underway now shortly.
University of Manchester first out again.
Yeah.
He's going to take off with stretches like that, isn't he?
Do you think there's any psychological reason for going out first?
Maybe. I don't believe it if there is, but maybe.
Yeah, I know Mamet have come up as well for the second half. UniOv just need to impose themselves a bit more in this game, maybe get more involved in the MMU territory, because a lot of the ball was in MMU hands in that first half. But it's a new half now, and things could change. The score is even, and that's all that matters. So Reed there with the start off again, and the second half is underway. Calvert with the ball now out towards the centre. And Mamet with the ball. Mamet with the ball, moving up to the left-hand side. That's another period you and Mamet gained good ball possession, which was characteristic of the first half there.
Start off as you mean to go on.
Yes, there's been another good start here by MMU. Now Wilson just... And I think they decided there was no advantage, so MMU gone for the penalty. Wise decision there. And they can kick the ball and go into a better, stronger territorial position like they have. And they will be having the line-out.
Almost hit the steward on the head. That would have been funny. For those that are listening to this, if you press the red button soon, you can translate Josh's very difficult Welsh into English subtitles.
You're just waiting for that one.
Waiting the whole game.
So we've got a line-out now for MMU, taken by Nern. Probably the fourth different pronunciation of his name I said during this game. I do apologise, George Nern.
Don't you say his name if you're apologising. I'll say it. Where's it spelled? Have we got it spelled written down? There we go. George Nern.
Nern.
That's what I'm going with. Please, email us in if that's wrong. Our email. I don't know what our email is. Don't email us in.
alex.wickham@student.manchester.ac.uk. Any complaints, email that address. He is the producer of our commentary this evening. So we got an MMU penalty, so we got to sidetrack a bit there. So we have penalty from MMU, and it is kickable, and Brownrow will be hoping to make this and give MMU the 3-point lead here.
This is the easiest one they've had all game, this.
Yes.
Hopefully he's took his slippers off and put his boots on for the second half. Oh, and the slippers are still on. Slippers are still on. BHS, 2-for-1, £5. Straight over.
And the scores remain Unior 5, MMU 5. So Unior about to get us back underway. Reed with the kick. And it's a high looping ball there. And tackle that. Chapman just being tackled. Slow ball here by MMU. But again, the trend has continued in the opening minutes of this half with a lot of MMU ball going through a lot of phases.
Exactly what they'll want.
Mm-hmm. Imposing themselves back into the second half. And the ball was number 10. And it's been given to Kelly, who's done another driving run. And just been taking two players to tackle him there.
One to take his body, the other one for his haircut.
Yeah. And pulls back out onto the left hand side. Now with Wilson, who's bringing the ball out to you. There's numbers again over there for MMU, and just couldn't do it. There, Brownrow just couldn't release Wilson there. And that's going to be a penalty for MMU. And into touch is going to be a line out. Successful lineup there by MMU. And now moving ball to the left again. Another lock, quick ball again. You know, definitely what they'd want so far in the opening half. Right on the left-hand touchline here. bringing the ball onto the right-hand side now.
It's a bit strictly come dancing more than rugby union, that one. Watching Ed Bowles do rugby union would be interesting, wouldn't it?
No, not really. Why would that be interesting?
I don't know. Watching him on Strictly is quite interesting. I think he'd be good on this. He's got the build of a rugby player. Better at rugby than he is politics.
We have a player down at the moment. Getting some treatment off the physio. Looked like cramp, but looked like cramp there, the way the physio was dealing with the leg.
Yeah.
Obviously.
I'm no doctor. He could have broke his leg, as far as I know.
Yeah, same. Could have been an arm injury, for as far as I'm concerned.
Could
but it appeared to be a leg injury.
Maybe he's just bored, riding his imaginary bike. You never know. Who are we to judge, Josh?
Exactly.
We're here to comment.
Tit.
Don't call me that. Oh, we're back underway.
Here we go. So the break and play is over, by the looks of it, and we're going to be having an MMU scrum.
He's locked his bike to the gates and he's ready to get back on the pitch.
And once again, Wilson is going to be delivering the ball.
Wilson! Tom Hanks reference now?
I didn't get it, personally.
It's fine. Those at home will.
Okay. Ooh, they've taken a quick penalty and the ref has stopped that. Annoying to see where they went, MMU, they went for the quick tap and go.
No, there's no speed.
The ref has brought it back for the penalty, and it looks like, are they going to kick it for touch? Or are they going to go for 3 points? They're going for the five again. So, yeah, a little bit far out there, that does make sense. They go in some territory, and they got some good territory there inside the 22. Line out for MMU, taken by George.
George, how well do you know him?
Not going to say his surname.
Oh, can you, is that the one you can't say?
Yeah. So, and we've got a drive on here now. MMU are making a lot of ground here with this drive.
It's George Nguyen. So fast he is. It's a compliment.
We have another scrum.
Well, why not, eh? We've had enough. Let's have another one. Take two while you're there. Why not? Is this the most exciting game you've ever watched, Josh?
So it's not bad. It's pretty. It's not a bad game.
Oh, middle of the road, isn't it? Middle of the road.
It's not. At least it's not too stop-starty, which is kind of sometimes a big stain on rugby matches.
We say at the 25th score of the match.
But it's not. It hasn't been too stop-starty. It's been pretty good so far. Finally poised, still at 5-0. And now we're quite close to the... Union Upper, better be careful, yeah. They're quite close to their try line, and that's a good kick out there. They did well to erase any danger there.
Oh, there's a big Mexican wave going on down there. Really getting into the spirit.
Quite difficult when only part of the one stand is full for a Mexican definitely. Wave. Doesn't really work. Okay, now
it's like a mini wave, like a little microwave.
Line up by George again.
A poppy ping, if you will.
No, stop. No, please. Terrible reference. Okay, now Uni over the ball. That's a good chance here for a break. Ooh, that was a high tackle. Surely that was a high tackle. Well, the ref hasn't given it. Well, that was a... that appeared there that he was a very high tackle. He hasn't. I think he's given it for the infringement in the ruck, though. But who am I to judge?
We're here to comment, aren't we?
We are. And there's going to be a penalty for MMU.
just slowed down a little bit this game, hasn't it? From the rapid start that Man Met came out with.
It's still on top, still well on top though.
Still well on top.
Uniov can't really seem to get with a half at the moment. And he's gone off to get the ball, boys. He's had to go and get the ball himself.
That wasn't Nylander the Vigilante, was it? Going getting it. Putting on his cape.
And the ball has been retrieved, and we're going to be coming back now for a MMU lineout.
I'm going to get so many nasty emails, aren't I?
Like I said earlier, if you could have any critique or comment on our match commentary, please send it to our producer at alex.wickham@student.manchester.ac.uk, because we'd love the feedback, and this is the first time we've actually ever commentated.
So we'd For those that can't tell.
We would love your feedback as well, so please send it to our producer and then we will take all your comments on board.
Any ladies' underwear that you'd like to send in the post can be sent to the University of Manchester Students' Union. Or men's underwear. Why not? No jock straps.
Okay, back to the game anyway, because we've gone off a bit of a tangent there. So
just a little one.
Okay, Man Met with the ball now deep in the Uni of 22, and they're making inroads now. Number 10, Brown Row. Given off to Perry. Perry's broke through that tackle well, and it's taken four, five men there to bring Aaron Perry down. And number eight. And then Chapman moving inroads there now with scrum half Wilson, who gives the ball to George.
Some great strength there from Man Met.
Yeah, they're still holding up the tackling well. Nice decision by the referee. And MMU are well on top here at the moment in this game. And it is going to be a scrum. MMU scrum, and they're well on top at the moment, Harry.
So on top. They've come out this second half so much the better team. It's not even close at the minute.
Yes. Uni are definitely hanging on at the moment. They do need to think of some new ideas to get themselves. It's not panic stations yet, because the score is still 5-5.
It's no problem.
One score can turn the game, but they do need to turn the momentum in their favour.
There is only one statistic that matters, isn't there?
It's the scoreline.
Scoreline.
Which is 5-5. So, it's about to get the scrum started here. Going to be ball put in again.
Boy's own formation.
Bonnie Wilson. Does seem to be we're saying the same names over and over again as well, to be fair. There's been a few players who've had quite a big impact so far in this game. MMU scrum half Wilson being one of them.
Kelly's been one of my favourite, not just for the haircut. Although primarily for the little ponytail thing going on.
And we're going to have a retake of this scrum.
Do you think he'll send us a lock of his hair to the Students' Union?
I can ask him, but it'd be a little bit weird, wouldn't it?
Probably would be, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
I think we'll miss that one out.
Yeah.
As long as there's no taped evidence of me saying that, then that's fine.
Well, there's going to be a second taken of this scrum. They're going to be put in by Wilson.
Wilson!
And successful scrum. MMU have started a drive here. And they've given the penalty. The ref has given a pen. Been quite a well-natured game so far as well.
Yeah, there's been no nastiness going on.
Been no handbags, which is always good to see. Okay, it's going to be a scrum here, and MMU ball.
Scrummage. Another scrummage. I'm going to scrummage in this bag for another lucky star, actually. Oh, we're out. Fantastic. Tell you what, get nothing from this job, do we?
No, our producer Alex has not given us enough beverages and enough snacks to keep us going.
Didn't even queue up for a hot pie.
It's okay, scrum here now. It's going to be delivered in. And oh, and close to the try line, and Man Met now are very close. just a few yards, and this is going to take a lot of defensive spirit.
Could all this pressure be about to take off?
To keep this ball out, and it's very close. Just a few yards, and now they're bringing the ball out open on the left-hand side, and that's a try. And MMU's dominance in this second half has been rewarded, finally, with the try. And
it's been coming, hasn't it?
It has been coming, and there was a lot of numbers then on the right-hand side. They exploited those numbers as well, and they have retaken the lead here, and it is Uni of Manchester 5, Manchester Metropolitan 10, and there's the crowd. They're quite happy at the moment, and they should be. Their team is well on top and have been rewarded with the try. And this is traditionally where the crowd banter comes in.
Crowd banter. Everyone loves it, don't they?
I know.
What's your favourite chant, Josh?
My favourite chant?
Do you have one?
No, not personally.
Oh, wow.
What about you?
Oh, I don't know.
What about I'd rather live in Baghdad than Man Met?
That's quite a good chant. I like the one, your dad's a Tory.
From who says this?
Man Met to UoM. It's not true, my dad's not a Tory.
No.
But still slightly funny. I don't think I'm the one that it's aimed at, though, really.
Well, we've got a conversion here, which is coming up for MMU to put 7 points distance between themselves and Uni off.
Could this so be far, the first successful one?
There has not been a successful kick so far this evening. So, let's see. And no.
Definitely a sail on slippers.
Wasn't converted, and the score then is Uni off 5, MMU 10, so it's a 5-point lead. I think it's fair to say it's been a deserved lead for MMU. They have been the better team.
Yeah, they just edged the first half, but this second half, it's just been all Man Met.
So Uni of Men, hopefully can draw a line under this and maybe get back into the game now, and with a good kickoff. And you've got the game is back underway, and not the best of kicks there from Uni of in the start off. And the ball has already been turned over and back to MMU.
They had a great response from MMU's first try.
And they would be hoping for a similar response now, but it doesn't look that way. And they've even got the ball back in the up and under. And the pattern of the game does appear to be continuing as well. MMU have just got the ball and they've just seemed to get him right back into it. Union territory as well. So the try is just, more than anything, it's continued MMU's control of this game.
Good to see that there's a passion for rugby even up in the gantry, though, isn't it?
It is.
As fellow producer Ali is currently painting her nails in the gantry. Is that okay? I don't think that's okay. And a shake of the head from fellow producer.
I don't think you're going to be doing the commentary any longer after today.
I think that ship sailed quite a long time ago, Josh.
So anyway, back to the game. It's a scrum, a Uni off scrum. No magic stars left.
As much as I try. Try. It's nothing to try.
Okay. Scrum again, and it's going to be delivered in by the scrum half Calvert. Apparently, it was given then as a tap and go, and Uni off are on the charge here. Looking to get back into this game.
I feel it's pretty rude of me that I've not mentioned Rimmer's hair this game.
Big fan?
Big fan. Mm. Looks a little bit like...
He does have a nice little barnet going on.
I know. It's like Tarzan of the modern day.
Anyway, number three tackle there. Salah has just been tackled, and the ball... No, this is a bit better by Uni. They're getting a bit more of the ball, going through the phases.
This is the response we want from them.
And just as I say that...
The commentator's curse.
The commentator's curse there, and the... So, with the final 70 minutes left of this game now, and it'll be a MMU scrum. Would you like to have a guess how many scrums there have been so far in this game?
I can guess whatever I want. We've got no statistics. I'm going to go with 17.
Well, no.
Have you been counting?
Yes. No, I haven't. Round about 12, I make it.
well?
We have no idea. Please email us in if you know how many scrums there are.
Statmans? Any statisticians?
Try again one more time.
Statisticians?
God. The red button subtitle maker didn't like that one, did he? Bad enough in Welsh.
So we're going to second take of this MMU scrum. And that looks a bit better. That looks a lot better. Now MMU back on the charge here with Kelly, and another really good run here by Frank Kelly. And he's just been stopped there. Now he's just been tackled. But again, that's, I make that at least the third time there that Kelly has made a very big dart in running to the forward positions. He's done well there. Now MMU back with the ball. So Kelly again with the ball, moving now towards the just behind there, and
picked it back up though.
Picked it back up, and that's out for a line-out Unior ball, and they really need to start getting themselves back into this game, because at the moment the next score is looking more likely to come from
MMU.
MMU.
And then it's, well, it's not out of touch then, you're not, you know, it's,
no, it's still, UoM could still, come still back one that, score away, still one score away. One converted try there in the lead, but this game is definitely being in the grasp.
He's riding his bike again. He's down, he's going to ride his invisible bike. Just shows how much they're putting into the game, doesn't it, this?
It does.
It's two cramps already from Man Met.
Yes. This is a very important game, and they are giving it their all.
A little break in play, Josh. Would you like a jammy dodger?
We don't have any jammy dodgers. Producer Alex hasn't given us any.
Oh, fantastic.
If you'd like to recommend to Alex what snacks to give us for the next time we ever do a commentary on a varsity game, please email him at alex.wickham@student.manchester.ac.uk.
Collective groan when you just said, when we next do a commentary for the varsity.
What? Okay, so line out for Uniov. Rimmer with the ball in, and that is a successful line out. Now the ball there with Hunt. Moved in field a little bit there.
He's not the Jay Hunt, is he? It just says Jay there. He's not Jeremy Hunt. We could have Ed Bowles and Jeremy Hunt playing this. That'd be great.
No political references, please, in a game of rugby.
No, I will not make any comment about Jeremy Hunt.
Thank you.
Jeremy Hunt.
Okay, so it's Uniov ball. And a little bit of a spoot there. Decision. Like I said, again, it is very difficult to sometimes without the ref having a mic.
The ref's mic.
Where we can hear exactly what he's saying to the players and stuff like that anyway. But it's a Uniov penalty, and they're going to be trying to gain some territory here by kicking the ball into touch. And there's been a substitution there for Uniov as well. Nice kick. And Uniov will be having a line-up.
It's nice to see the ball on the other half, isn't it? Oh, and slappy bottom Chino, man. That was at the beginning of the game.
On the touchline.
Slapping bottoms
people.
Again.
Yep.
It's nice.
Trying to rev people up here.
I hope he knows them people.
You'd like to think so, wouldn't you?
Yeah. Hmm. It's a nice way to get to know someone.
So line up UM ball. Good line up there. And now, it wasn't a good. Obviously, the decision has been reversed. I think that was because of a knock-on or non-straight line-out.
I think while we've got a little break, we can ask Ali what colour she's painted her nails.
What colour is that?
Burgundy.
Ooh. Not watching the game, deciding to paint her nails in this cold, crisp weather.
It's dark red for those that aren't sure.
Yeah. to match the seats.
Yeah, that's why she did it.
So scrum MMU ball.
Remember earlier when you said this game wasn't very stop-start?
Yeah, it's definitely got a lot more stop-start, you know, in the second half. And that actually suits UniOrv, I'd say, though. It definitely does suit them because they were losing it. We're losing control of this game. MMU were getting a lot of the ball. They were being allowed to play their rugby. But now with the stop-start, it does kind of stop the momentum of MMU a little bit. So I think this definitely does help UniOrv a lot more, especially being in MMU's half at the moment as well. So it's kind of the breakup they needed, really, to
definitely
kind of halt the momentum. MMU back with the ball here on this left-hand side, and it's a nice little run. It's taking 3 men to stop him. Also very apparent in this game as well is how quick, actually, when they do have the ball, how quick MMU are getting into UniOrv's half and their territory. Really are struggling at the moment, our UniOrv. Haven't had a really notable chance yet either.
No,
a notable moment in the second half.
Not at all. Still time though, we're optimists.
Still 19 minutes to go.
We could win this 35.
Just the 30-10,
not 35.
Just
not
the
that
one.
Good.
Still just the one try. And MMU will be aware of that as well. They will know that one mistake could cost them the game. So it's a line out to MMU. Going to be taken in there by George, and that's a successful lineup.
George New.
Oh God. Another drive here by MMU, and they're making a lot of ground here. They're driving towards the UniOrv try line, and this does spell danger. Numbers on the right hand side, lot of numbers over on the right. They just need to get the quick ball out there. And it's been turned over, and UniOrv have got the ball back. And we'll be hoping for a break here. I must say as well, I think I said there was 90 minutes to go just now, but at the clock, it's actually 8. So my maths is terrible. So it is actually.
It's a little longer than 8, though.
8 minutes to go. Another break in play now. It has definitely got a lot more stops out. You know, players are starting to get tired and stuff like that.
Physio's on again. Two physios. There's two bicycles.
I'd like to say, just make one point as well of how awful the MMU kit is.
Do you not like that?
Not a fan of the white, black, and orange mix.
I
to be honest,
I like it.
No, I'm not a fan.
I do like ours.
But then
ours,
I'll be honest. Then I don't like UniOrv's either.
I think I prefer UniOrv's.
Kit game is very poor in this game. Colour blends are not good.
Are you a fan of the gold and purple of UniOrv?
No.
Just in general?
No.
I don't think it works, does it?
No, I don't think it works either.
Well.
So yeah.
Commentators, they never said what we have to comment on.
No, exactly.
They've had haircuts, kits.
So if you had to choose a kit, what would you choose?
What, out of these two?
Of the colours, yeah.
Any
the colour schemes.
Any colour. I wear black everywhere, but
no, I mean, what you choose in the cup? What kit would you choose?
Out of them two?
Yeah.
UniOrv.
I would as well.
Nicer design.
Doesn't mean I like it, though. and we're going to go to the crowd.
Tell you what, Josh, it's been quite surprising that it's not rained today. You can feel it in the air.
It's been very nice.
It's been very nice.
Yeah, it's been quite cold. But it's been nice conditions to play rugby in as well.
Well, they've brought me big coat, haven't they?
Yeah.
Brought me big coat.
You wrapped up as well with your scarf and your nice little bobble hat.
uni of bubble hat, I'll have you know.
Yes, I have noticed.
Not that I am not impartial.
Where'd you buy that from?
Take three wild guesses.
Uni Place.
I thought it was University of Manchester, that's where I got it from. No, Bistros.
Oh, nice. Not a bobble hat fan myself.
That's a little bit insulting.
Fair. Right then, for back of the game, it's a little break-up because of the scrums. It's obviously, scrums take ages.
Still
digging.
Who's
AJ Bell, anyway, by the way?
That is a fantastic question. If only we had a researcher nearby.
Only if one of our co-producers, Ali, could have a look.
She can't, her nails are still wet.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, scrum has been delivered in, another successful scrum. No turnovers in scrums tonight, though, that's been quite good. In the scrum side of things, and now MMU driving towards again the try line. This could spell some danger for UniOv. This could spell a lot of danger, and it's very close to the line. Has that gone over? No,
it could be all over soon.
Just a couple of yards away, and UniOv are scrapping for their lives here. If they do score your MMU, the game would be pretty much over. And it's going very close now. And I think that's gone out of touch. There. And the ref has brought it back. But they're living very dangerously now, UniOv. I'm on a scrum. Haven't seen one of these today.
I've seen more scrums than I've had hot dinners this week. That is the most Manx saying.
You wouldn't have about 18 hot dinners in a week, would you?
Let's say this month then.
That's better.
Thank you. I'm glad we worked through this.
Hey, scrum UniOv anyway, and there is the final 3 minutes of the game now. And the crowd is now, the Man Met side of the crowd is getting
wasted, I think, is the answer there, isn't it? They look wasted.
Sounds maybe think they've won the game now and again, a bit more vocal.
I think they have been the most vocal of the fans.
The noise levels have definitely been in their favour.
Although the team have made it easy for them, haven't they? They've been outnumbered as well in the fans. There's a lot more UoM here.
They've still got a chance though. UniOv aren't out of this game yet.
Nope, and Tarzan here.
Just the one score, and they will be back on terms. The one converted try, and they will be in the lead. So, still a lot to play for.
Producer Ali can barely contain herself.
But they've just got to, UniOv have to do something that they haven't done throughout the half, and that is really go deep into the MMU territory. It's been quite one-sided, but they've still got a chance here now with the ball. And the closer they get to the end of the game, the more nervous MMU will get. So, chance now.
This is what we want, isn't it? A bit of a fight, come on.
UniOv aren't ready to give in yet. They're still with the ball now, trying to get forward.
Bit of dancing on ice there. Or Bambi on ice.
Tap and go, and
the ref does not like that, does he?
Ref said that he could do a tap and go, and has not allowed him through the tap and go. So UniOv will be doing the penalty to try and go towards goal, a bit of territory, and there's a nice kick, and we'll be having a line out just outside the MMU 22, and there the UniOv crowd are trying to.
Nothing says a UniOv crowd than somebody with chinos flapping, does it?
Yeah, and a beige light blue shirt. They're getting behind UniOv though, trying to drive them on now in the final minute of this game. One try is all they need now to try and get back in this game. And that's a disappointment there. Rimmer was disappointing there with the line-out, the intercepted line-out. That was a good chance for UniOv there.
It's an important moment that they've just squandered.
Yes, and Rimmer will be disappointed there. So now Manmet have the ball. Manmet just trying to see this out now. Oh, they've kicked it long, which is a
interesting tactics so close to the end of the game. It's given the ball straight back to UoM. They would probably be more sensible to keep the ball themselves.
It's like you said, the nerves at the end of the game, that.
Yes. And now UoM coming forward now. It's probably the longest spell they've had in the MMU half in this second half.
Yeah, I agree.
Now just trying to carve an opening now, try and find a way through.
It's the first bit of defending that Man Met have had to do, isn't it, really?
Yes. Pretty much the whole game, apart from the try.
Maybe that was the tactic, surprise them in the last minutes with defence.
Well, anyway, it's MMU ball. In these closing stages of the game now. And MMU are very nearly there. They will be
just in time for a noisy youth club to move in the gantry. We'll get rid of them. We'll send a producer.
There's a few more cramps going on as well. Just evident of how everyone has given their all today. Jinx, 1, 2, 3.
My God, we just said that on camera.
Oh, Jesus. Anyway, we've got to go in for the scrum here now. And it's going to be delivered in by the number 17, Will Curtis. I'm at a very close to the finishing line now. Good scrum.
They've waited so long for a win against UoM.
It's very nearly there as well. They can feel it. They can taste it.
Can smell it.
Yeah.
Great play.
Oh, my mate, have the ball. Just try and run the clock down a bit now. Just keep the ball. It should be there. And it's going to be a line out for MMU. They keep them.
It's a nice try, that, isn't it?
Jordan Rimmer there, or Jay Rimmer with the hand on his hips. He's given his all tonight.
He has. Our Tarzan. I hope that catches on.
Rimmer is the MMU, the UoM of Tarzan.
Yes. Yeah, I like that.
His nickname could very well be Tarzan.
Maybe I'm not that original. Maybe that's already a thing.
Line out MMU anyway. It'll be taken by George.
Yeah.
A successful line out as well. That was a big line out, and MMU have got it. So another stop in play.
You had a nice time today, Josh.
I had a splendid time.
It's nice to have bonded with one another, isn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely.
I feel well enough to scrum with you now. And even if our university does lose, I've got some fantastic shots for Instagram.
Well, we won't be thinking of that. At the moment, we're going to be still positive. We're hoping they can get back in the game.
Also, as neutrals, we also don't
care.
No,
we're not neutral. We're
we'll
definitely UoM. Come on.
As a University of Manchester medicine student myself.
Medicine student? They don't what modules you taking this year?
The early Roman Republic. Okay, I don't do medicine. I couldn't even. Oh, you've ruined that.
Trying to take credit to doing medicine.
I could do medicine.
Everyone knows I'm the true medic here.
I do history.
That's crap. So the kick forward there by MMU, and they've got a little bit of territory there.
There's not long left.
Look at that for a close up. You can have that profile picture and everything, can't you?
It's all done. Okay, we've got a line-out coming up now then.
It's not going down with a bang, this game, is it? It's
no.
Going out with a bit of a whimper at the minute.
Which has been a bit disappointing, because this game has been quite free-flowing and nice up until this period. It's quite natural when people start to get tired. And
first half was so much better as well.
So, Uni over the ball now.
Took a couple of kicks to the head there.
Ooh, was a bit well caught there. It was a bit of a low pass by the scrum half. He did well there to hold on to it. Okay, and the ref has blown that, and it is a penalty for Uniov. Yes, and they're going to be kicking for touch. There we go, and that's a good kick there.
Just got a little bit interesting now, didn't it?
It has, and Uniov are very close now to the try line, so, and the crowd have shown their backing as well. There they are, making it. Making some noise, making sure they get behind the team. It has to be noted as well, a lot of people in the crowd as well would know the players on a personal level as well.
Yeah.
Which gives them even more reason to support them.
Do you know anyone in the
friends.
Team?
Myself, no. You?
No. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been this rude about all of the haircuts.
So it's lying up very close now to the try line. You know, this is the closest they've been by the whole second half. And they're trying to institute a drive here, and it's not really in motion there. MMU have stood tall there. Trying to get into the driving mall. So now Uniov just a few. Oh, and the penalty's been given there. That was a good chance for Uniov. And MMU have passed that test there.
There's hands on heads from
that
a few
was,
there from UoM. Yeah. That is a shambles. Not a shambles.
That was
shambles.
First time there that MMU had to defend this second half, and they've passed the test in flying colours there. They've done well. It'd be disappointing for Uniov there. You have to state as well that there's still only one score in this game, one try. We'll change the complexion of this. One converted try, and Uniov would be in the lead.
Said it's well defended, I'm going to come into it.
And it's a scrum. Another scrum.
Scrummage.
Okay, so we got the scrum there, MMU, good scrum. That's there, the number 17, Will Curtis with the ball out. And now MMU, ooh, nice bit of running, and they're trying to get forward there. That was a nice run there by Connor Wilkinson. And that's a penalty there. Yes, it is a penalty, Ali. And MMU.
That's a nice kick there into touch. And MMU will have the line out in uni of half.
See a future career in commentating, Josh?
Not in rugby, no.
More of a football man?
I am. But I do like a game of rugby. I like playing rugby.
Ah, well, the Welsh do. Not all of you.
Yeah, and that also brings us to the point again. Obviously, me and Harry, this is our first time commentating, and we'd love to have your feedback. And if you could send it to our head producer at alex.wickham@student.manchester.ac.uk, please. Thank you. We'd appreciate the feedback. Okay, so now we have lineup taken by George. Lineout, successful lineout there by MMU.
Oh, short back and size has dropped it.
And that, yeah. I'm in.
It's a shame that the angle of the camera's from this way, isn't it? That you can't see the crowd. Still fantastic filming from Fuse TV. Just letting everyone know that the crowd are going.
They try their best, Harry. They're volunteers who do a very good job.
I know, we're part of it. Although we have been paid in Magic Stars today.
Uni of scrum.
I was lacking jammy dodges, though.
Chocolate fingers would have gone down a storm as well.
Chocolate fingers?
Yeah. But anyway, scrum.
There's a lot of fist pumping and hooligan shouting there, isn't there? They're up for this now, man, Matt. Just got to see this one out. For a historic win.
All about game management now when it gets to this period of the game. Trying to see it out. And there's a few ways you can go, see. You can either go there, do you get another try? More positive to finish the game off? Or do you try and see the game out? Because one score and the game would be all over. That is quite clear.
And they've had such a fantastic attack this game. That would be a difficult decision to make, wouldn't it? Because they're obviously better at attack.
Yes. Their offence has been...
offensive.
Yeah. And they got the ball back here again. Good play there by Uni of. This defence stood firm there in the ruck. They've got the penalty as well.
Well, the defence hasn't been that bad today.
They've held out quite well. They've had a lot of tackling to do. They've made a number of tackles. They've had a lot of defending to do. So in that regard, they have done very well. It's just...
the physio one again. They made a glass, these players. I shouldn't say that. I'm sat here in a commentary booth.
Yeah.
I'm not out there playing.
Exactly.
Well played, lads.
You're doing your unis proud.
Yes. Yeah, another scrum here now. And Uni of have come out with the ball there.
Okay, now Uni of with the ball. Trying to get a bit more forward here now. And that, that looks like a bit, was that a knock-on? It wasn't a knock-on. And there's been a turnover ball though, and there's ruck now. Bit of a messy ruck, but MMU have come away with the ball, and that's been kind of the story of the game, really. Whenever Uni of have tried to establish maybe a foothold in the game or something, MMU have always taken it back. But there's a penalty, and a good opportunity here for Uni of to gain some ground and become more forward and get closer to the MMU line, and that is a nice kick.
I don't think...
It wasn't a good kick. It didn't end up going into touch. It looked like it was a good... It had a good distance, but the direction of the kick wasn't good enough. And MMU have the ball again. That is such a... Must be so annoying.
It's been frustration after frustration.
Yeah, that was very frustrating. I know the game is nearly over now. It's towards the closing parts. And MMU kicked it out. And that surely brings the full-time whistle. And it does. And MMU have won the 2016 Rugby Varsity. Scenes of jubilation.
Unhappy chinos everywhere.
On the field. And the...
Oh, one woman's got the ball that won the game. She is overjoyed with that. Oh, it's a challenge.
MMU have won the game. And obviously UniOv looked dejected down the field, but MMU are joyous.
I have a feeling we could very well get a Cortinas-esque mosh pit here now. They're all coming in.
And it's finished anyway, it's finished. Uni of Manchester 5, MMU 10.
It's been a pleasure, Josh.
Thanks for listening, guys.